the Arabs, it turns out, had built this massive empire overnight that embraced knowledge and was shockingly tolerant. It was similar to the Persian Empire. In fact, it's really remarkable because if you look at the area that the Arabs conquered, they conquered everything from Spain to Pakistan when they built their empire. It was like the Persian Empire plus most of the Roman Empire combined. So it was bigger than any empire that had preceded it. One of the things that's remarkable about it was the majority of the world's Christian population was in that empire. 60% of all of Christendom was in that Muslim-ruled Arab empire. In its first couple of centuries, there were almost no Muslims in the Arab Empire. They were the rulers, but they were like 5% of the population because they didn't force anybody to convert. So not only did they end up with the majority of the Christian population of Earth, but they were majority Christian also. And it was okay. They were tolerated. That Christian population was tolerated and integrated into their society because they were a tolerant empire. Now, what's remarkable about this is they began to advance human knowledge. The lens, invented by Ibn al-Haytham, the same guy who invented the camera, he's also the guy who realized that light traveled at a finite speed in waves and could be broken down into its constituent colors, and that all objects in the universe exert gravity on each other. He also invented the world's first ever scientific method. He stated Newton's first law of motion 600 years before Newton, dabbled in calculus 600 years before Leibniz and Newton, stated Kepler's first law of planetary motion 500 years before Kepler. There was Ibn Sina, the guy who invented modern medicine. He's also the guy who came up with the idea of singularities. He effectively postulated Big Bang. He's the guy who kicked off phenomenology that Husserl and Heidegger will later on take on and develop further. Right? There was this huge blossoming of scientific and philosophical knowledge in that time period. Ibn Khaldun, the father of political science, the father of history, the father of sociology. The Arabs invented literary studies where you would look at literary sources for the purposes of trying to figure out what the truth was, for the purpose of trying to understand, in other words, the English departments all owe their existence to these guys. How can that much be carved out of your historical knowledge when all of it is Western? That's the key to this. The knowledge that the Arabs were building off of was Western. The knowledge that they made was Western. And the answer is that what we did was we intentionally created this East-West paradigm to divorce the Arabs and the Persians from the rest of the West. That this was an intentional thing, right? Al-Khwarizmi invented algebra, algorithms, zero, Arabic numerals. You can't jettison these guys. They're too much of our foundational understanding of the universe, right? What would we be without algebra and algorithms to mine your internet activity and then launch really nice ads directly aimed at you, customized for you, to get you to buy stuff you don't need? How many times have you opened an app or something and saw the ad that was exactly about what you were just talking to somebody? It's creepy.